What's up guys, Ryan here. So let's talk about the new Galaxy Fold 5 and some issues that need to be addressed that you definitely need to know before you click buy. This is not a review video, but honestly Samsung has made it easy for me this year to review this phone even if I don't have it, and I'll tell you why, but let's first take a look at the history of the Fold series. So back in 2019, Samsung released the Galaxy Fold, and it was really exciting. It was something that none of us had ever experienced before. And for the first time, it replaced the Mighty Note series as the new flagship phone. It was kind of ugly though, with a small screen to body ratio of only 85.7% and those camera cutouts by today's standards. Then comes the Galaxy Fold 2 the next year. And this looked way better in my opinion. The ugly camera cutout was gone and the inner display came with 120Hz refresh rate, and the screen to body ratio was improved by almost 3%. And at the same time, the resolution got better with higher pixel density. They bumped the battery capacity too from 4,380 mAh to 4,500, and the fast charging was increased to 25 watts. Now, even though I usually don't recommend upgrading the phone each year, I'd have definitely considered an upgrade from Galaxy Fold to Fold 2 a valid and respectable choice. Moving on to the next year with Fold 3, the cover screen also got a better display with 120Hz refresh rate for the first time. It also got IPX8 water resistant rating, a tough armor aluminum, and support for an S Pen for the first time. But probably the biggest selling point of it was this one feature, an under display camera for the first time. It was a big deal. It came with a disadvantage though. The under-display camera was only 4 megapixels. 4 megapixels in 2021. And this is where things take a turn, and it brings me to this question that I have. Have we plateaued in terms of the innovation and the package and excitement that we get for our money? I mean, the Fold 5 is barely any different than Fold 4. That under-display camera from 2021 that I just talked about is exactly the same, hasn't changed. The screen to body ratio has improved by only like 0.2%. We're stuck with the 25 watt fast charging, and the freaking battery capacity is still 4,400 mAh. And if you recall, that was 4,500 on Fold 2. So why does this phone even exist? That's my next question, and I want you to answer this in the comments. I want to know what your thoughts are. Why do they keep pumping these phones out into the market if they're barely any different than their predecessors? Of course, I know the answer myself. Or I guess I know, and that's because these launch events are sometimes merely a promotional campaign to sell their tech with a new name attached to them. But just a disclaimer here, I've had Samsung phones my entire life and I use them every day and I love them. My discussions are always from the perspective of the end users. But does that mean that the Galaxy Fold 5 is a bad phone or it's not worth it? Oh, absolutely not. It's an amazing phone. I used the Galaxy Fold 4 for a while last year and it was pretty cool. And in case you're wondering what did really change in Fold 5 that was a little more impactful than a 0.2% increase in the screen to body ratio, well, obviously the processor changes every year and the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 is one of my favorites in terms of its efficiency and power that it delivers and the balance between these two. But that also means that despite not having any better battery capacity than Fold 4, it has a slightly better battery life. Another notable change is the use of UFS 4 technology as opposed to UFS 3.1 of last gen. And if I remember correctly, it has doubled the performance. So it means that it means faster read and write and potentially, again, less battery consuming. The Gorilla Glass has also been upgraded to Victus 2 and the hinge has become stronger. But my favorite is that it's 10 grams lighter than Fold 4. 10 grams is a big deal. I like that. My honest opinion is that the Galaxy Fold 5, despite being a really cool phone, shouldn't exist. There's really no point in manufacturing a new version unless it's meaningfully different. I'm not even gonna say radically different, but just meaningfully different. You know, easy to distinguish the two. And if you're wondering why I'm not still using my Fold 4, that's because I realized I literally only used it like 99% of the time unfolded. And I thought to myself, if I'm mainly using it as a tablet, as probably most people do, I might as well just use my awesome Tab S8 Ultra as a tablet and my other phone as a phone. know, because I already got a tablet. So, but if you're into that kind of device that's highly multifunctional, then the Galaxy Fold 5 won't disappoint you. Bottom line is that I only recommend this phone to two groups of people. You've either never had a Fold phone before, or you're upgrading from Fold 1 or 2. That's it. Not even Fold 3 because of the plateau thing that I talked about. And I have links in the description that you could use. Anyways, hope you liked and subbed. See you in the next one.